Now comes the actual concept, useMemoized. So what is the functionality of useMemoized is it will enable caching in your application. So for example, here we have got hello world as an output, right? So how many times you run this particular method fetch data, you will be fetching the output like hello world itself. So even if you run for 100 times, the output will be same hello world for 100 times. So every time you make a network call, you'll be getting the same filter options again and again. But every time you visit that particular page, that network call will be made. So in these kinds of scenarios, you can just make use of a cache in your application, and for which you can make use of useMemoized. It's a Flutter hook component here. So you may ask a question here, then how can we know if there is any change in the output? For example, so how we can observe that particular new output or change coming up? So it's very simple again here. So now let's get started with the tutorial. So the very first thing you need to make sure is, like, you need to add Flutter hooks to your dependencies in your project. So in our previous tutorials where we have dealt with Flutter hooks, we have already added this particular dependency. But for those who are watching this tutorial for the first time, I'm just insisting you to add this particular dependency before getting started so that you can make use of Flutter hooks in your project. So now let's get started by just importing the material.dart, and also we need to import Flutter hooks, but based on the requirement we'll be importing them later. So now let's specify void main, and within this let us specify run app and specify my app, which is a stateless widget. Now we are going to specify it. So this is the basic structure of Flutter application. Almost all is same for every application. We have explained this particular structure line by line in our previous tutorials. You can just go through them if you are having any queries in this particular implementation. So now instead of container, let us try to return a material app. So now let us try to specify home as scaffold here. So scaffold provides the basic structure for our application, where we can just specify app bar and also the body here. And also if you are having any floating action buttons, you can just specify. And also there are a lot more properties. You can just go through the scaffold, and let's try to specify the title with the help of a text widget. And here I'm just specifying the basic, like, Flutter hooks. And now let's try to specify body over here. So now I'm going to specify one more class here, and this particular class will extend hook widget. So I'm just going to specify this, like, and now let's try to specify this particular class even. And now let us try to specify a stateless widget, and thereafter we will be trying to convert it into a hook widget here. Hook widget. Here you can see, as we have added dependencies here, we can just get the suggestions like this, and we can just select hook widget out of it, and which will automatically add an import here. So in earlier we have not added any import, right? So when we have selected hook widget from the drop down, from the suggestions available, the import is automatically added here. So you can just add either the way. You can just directly import at the initial stage, or you can just try to select out from the suggestion and that will add an import. And now instead of returning a container, I would like to return a center widget here. Before to that, let us try to specify a future method here, such that we will receive some data with a delay of 1 second, so that we can see the exact functioning of useMemoized here. So now let us try to specify future of type string here, and name this method like fetch data, which is of type asynchronous, and add await here future dot delayed. And here we need to specify duration, and in terms of seconds I'm specifying, and again you can just specify duration according to your requirement. And here you can find an error is being displayed here. The body might complete normally, causing null to be returned. So we need to return something here. So I'm going to return a message like hello world. So what exactly I'm trying to do over here is, like, I'm trying to make a delay of 1 second, and thereafter I'm trying to specify hello world as an output here. So just consider this particular scenario as a network call where you try to make a network call and wait for the output. So in the same scenario, I'm just trying to mock up that particular scenario here by making a delay of 1 second here, and after 1 second, we'll be getting hello world printed here. So you can just slightly increase the time duration here to 5 seconds or 10 seconds. And now let's specify a final variable future from where we would like to fetch the data. So fetch data here and specify one more variable snapshot such that we can read the data out of it. Use future and specify future here. And now within the center here, let's try to specify a child. And now let's try to read the data which we are getting. That is nothing but hello world we are getting after 1 second, right? So that particular data, now let us try to read it. Snapshot.data. So before trying to fetch the data directly, let us try to check whether it has data. So which returns a boolean value here. So if it has data, then only we'll try to read it, or else we can just display a circular progress bar until the data is loaded. That is like our data will be coming after 1 second, right? So till 1 second, we'll be loading a circular progress bar, and after the data is fetched successfully, display data onto the screen with the help of a text widget. So if it has data, then with the help of a text widget here. So now let's try to display the data present here. So snapshot.data. Until then, let's try to specify a circular progress indicator. Let's try to run this particular code and try to see the output before proceeding any further. Oh, here is a semicolon. We don't require it. So just remove the semicolon and try to run the code. And here we can see our progress bar is being displayed for a time period of 1 second, and then hello world is being displayed here. And now let's try to increase it to 10 seconds and try to save the code and try to rerun the code here. So here you can see our progress dialog is now displayed for 10 seconds and then our hello world is being displayed here. So likewise, you can just increase the duration and test this according to your requirement. And now comes the actual concept, useMemoized. So what is the functionality of useMemoized is it will enable caching in your application. So for example, here we have got hello world as an output, right? So how many times you run this particular method fetch data, you'll be fetching the output like hello world itself. So even if you run for 100 times, the output will be same hello world for 100 times. But you're having a delay here for like 10 seconds previously we are having. So every time to get the output, you need to wait for 10 seconds, right? So just compare this particular scenario to a network call. So whenever you're trying to make a network call and you're fetching the same data, for example, filter options in your application, so those options will not be changed, right? So every time you make a network call, you'll be getting the same filter options again and again. But every time you visit that particular page, that network call will be made. So in these kinds of scenarios, you can just make use of a cache in your application, and for which you can make use of useMemoized. It's a Flutter hook component here. Let's try to specify useMemoized. So the pronunciation may be a different. So just try to find the word here, useMemoized, and here let's try to specify fetch data here. And you just need to pass the fetch data here. So to make you understand this particular concept, let's try to add a variable that will help us to automatically make this particular method call here. I'm making use of useState here. Let's specify a final variable count equal to, I'm making use of useState here. So the useState will create a variable and will subscribe to it. So the initial count is like 0 here. And now let's try to increment the count value every time here. So count.value++. So why we are incrementing the count value here? What is the use? So don't worry, I will explain you very clearly. So within the hello world, let's try to include this particular value even. So count.value, and now try to run this particular code. So now let's try to remove useMemoized for now and try to run this particular code here. And now let's try to reduce the seconds to 1 here. And now try to observe the output here. Hello world 5, 6, 7, 8. So what we have done is we have taken the help of useState here and we are trying to increment the count every time. So for every 1 second we are trying to increment the particular count and try to specify the same as output here. So for every 1 second we are trying to fetch the output here. That is nothing but for every 1 second we are trying to call the fetch data. We are just waiting for 1 second and when we are and then we are getting the output like hello world and the value of the number according to the count variable here. So this is with a normal way of calling the particular fetch data method here. And now let's make use of useMemoized here. So useMemoized and let's specify fetch data here. And here we are now trying to run this particular code and try to observe the output here. So whenever you have specified useMemoized here, you can see the output is constant, that hello world 1 is not changing to 2, 3, 4 just like it was previously done. So what is the difference is like we have specified this particular component here which is a part of Flutter hooks useMemoized. So this will create a cache in your application and it will not try to recall the fetch data again and again. Instead it will use the same output which was generated for the first time. So you may ask a question here, then how can we know if there is any change in the output? For example, if there is any change in the filter option in future, or if there is any change in the output coming from this particular network call, let's suppose the fetch data is a network call method here. So how we can observe that particular new output or change coming up? So it's very simple again here. So in useMemoized, you will be having an option here. So you can just specify the key values here. So you can just specify the keys here and you can try to observe them. So for example, we have a count variable here and let us try to specify count here and let us try to observe the value here. So it's a value notifier. That's why every time we are making use of it, we are specifying dot value here. And even at the time of incrementing, we have specified value, and at the time of observing the output, then we have specified dot value here. And now let's try to run this particular code again and try to see the change here. So hello world 2, 3, 4, it's just running like before. Why? Because we are trying to assign this particular key here for useMemoized and asking it to refresh on every change here. So on every key change, so it will try to observe the key which we have specified like count out value, and if there is any change then it will try to recall the particular method fetch data every time. And by default, if we have not specified any keys here and we have tried to specify an empty constructor over here, then it will be called only once when the build method is called. That's all. So it's a simple way of explaining you the importance of useMemoized in your Flutter application. And I think you understood this particular topic. And if you are having any queries, do let me know in the comment section below. I will surely try to help you. So make use of this particular useMemoized as you require in your application. And also try to specify the key values accordingly, so that whenever there is any change, the fetch data method is called again and again, as you can see just now how it is running. So yes, this is it for this tutorial. And if you want to go through our previous tutorials on Flutter hooks, I'm just providing the link in the description section below, and the code for this tutorial is available in the description section below. And if you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.